Okay, first of all, talking about gamma ray, where does it reside in the electromagnetic spectrum? So here you can see this is the typical dimensions, and here gamma ray origin with the decay of atomic nuclear, which is shown over here. So we get gamma rays having wavelength of the order of fermi-meter. So that's, we know that, right? Now, so the question is, how do we see these gamma rays? You are talking, you are listening to me because you are enjoying this talk, or because you are seeing me and also you are hearing to me. So these gamma rays which I am going to talk about right now, the first thing we have to know is, how do we see them? Well, the answer is gamma ray spectroscopy. We observe them as this spectra counts versus energy. Typical spectrum as shown here, using a detector and associated electronics and computer system. A very simple system has been shown here. Yeah. So, you might be wondering that we just observe some spectra, and in spectra comes peak fitting, centroid. So, the question is this what we do in gamma ray spectroscopy? Unfortunately, or probably fortunately, it is not so, because the spectrum which I showed you just now, it was a spectrum of a monoenergetic gamma ray emitted from a decaying nucleus, but that is not a practical case. Very rarely we observe a nuclei decaying a single gamma ray. Normally what we observe is a nuclei decaying through a set of very closely aligned gamma rays, as you can see over here. So you see that our life is not very simple, but also we have to know, why is it so? The answer you will find here, approximately more than 3000, I think, nuclei, various types of nuclei that here are known to mankind even now. And each of them has various different types of structure. They, when you excite them, they behave differently, and gamma spectroscopy is one of the ways of knowing their character, how they behave. I'm not going again into the details of it. So the next question, since this is a refresher course on electronics and computer science, which has got many practical applications, so you might be wondering, okay, well and good, so how does it help me in my daily life? Well, again, we all know that, isn't it? Very one of the simple, very highly useful applications is nuclear medicine. When you inject a small amount of radioactive source inside the body, suppose there is some tumor and you inject it near there, and during the time of decay, you put detectors around it and you observe the gamma rays, and then you will be able to very nicely observe the metabolism of the tumor, and then you will be able to deduce what is the stage of its growth, and then you will be able to prescribe the particularly effective medicine for you. Well,